Hello students, today we will continue our chapter 8 motion for class 9. Now, measure of change of velocity. कैसे measure करेंगे बेटा? For this, we have a new quantity which is known as acceleration. It is change in velocity over time taken. Change in velocity over time taken. And it is a vector quantity. Why it is a vector quantity, beta? Because change in velocity and velocity, all of you know, it is a vector quantity. Why it is a vector quantity? Why velocity is a vector quantity? Because it has magnitude as well as, yes, direction. Very good. Now, we have formula for change in acceleration. Basically, velocity can change by changing its speed. If we change the speed of the object, then acceleration is there. And if we change the direction, then also we can say acceleration is there. So, the formula for acceleration is A, it is for acceleration, V minus U over T, where V is final velocity, U is initial velocity, and T is time taken. So, A is equal to V minus U over T. If we want to talk about the SI units of acceleration, can anybody guess? Yes, first what you have to do, you have to write the units of velocity over units of time. So, units of velocity is meter per second and for time is seconds. So, SI unit for acceleration is meter per second square and you can write like this also, both are correct. Is it clear to all of you? SI units are meter per second square, or you can write like this also. But you don't need to cram the SI units of the physical quantity. You can derive it by yourself like we have done acceleration ki. But first we write the formula, then we will write the units. And we can get the units of any physical quantity. Now, we have acceleration. It's of two type. Uniform acceleration and non-uniform acceleration. Two type of acceleration is there. If we talk about uniform acceleration, it is when velocity increases or decreases by equal amount in equal interval of time. What does it mean? When body is moving, when a car is moving, suppose it is increasing its speed or decreasing its speed equally in equal interval of time. That is known as uniform motion. Non-uniform motion, when velocity increases or decreases by unequal amount in equal interval of time. Now speed, when the object is moving, suppose first speed is 40 km per hour, then 50 km per hour, then suppose the velocity become 30 km per hour, then 50 km per hour. So time is same, but your velocity, it changes, or speed changes. That is known as uniform, non-uniform acceleration. Then your acceleration may be positive or negative. When velocity increases, your acceleration is always positive. When your velocity decreases, your acceleration is negative, or it is also known as deceleration, or it is also known as retardation. Is it clear? So negative acceleration is also known as deceleration or retardation. I hope this concept is clear. Now we have graphs. velocity time graph. Velocity time graph is also known as speed time graph. Both the graphs are same, and in numericals, if it is written velocity and they are if it is written speed, they asked you about velocity. In numericals, this is one and the same thing, velocity and speed. So here it can be named as velocity time graph or speed time graph. Both are the same. First one is for uniform acceleration. Here on y-axis we will plot velocity. We have to write the SI units and arrow. At x-axis, time, its unit, and arrow. Now here the time interval is shown 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, and velocity is shown 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. That's mean here a body is moving with the velocity of 10 meter per second again in first 5 seconds. In next 5 seconds, it again move with the velocity of 10. In next 5 seconds, again the velocity of 10. And when you make a graph, it will be a straight line. So for uniform acceleration, you are having a straight line. For non-uniform acceleration, see here, for non-uniform acceleration, the graph will not be straight line. It may be zigzag or some other. See here, time is 5 second, 10 second, 15 second, 20 second, like this. But here distance covered, but here object is moving with variable velocity. In first 5 second, it moves with 10. In next 5 second, it moves only with the speed of 5. In next 5 second, moves with 15 meter per second. And in next 5, it moves with 10. So, unequal velocity with equal interval of time. So, this is a graph for non-uniform acceleration. Now, our next graph is for uniform retardation. The velocity is decreasing as time increases, but at uniform rate. See here, 40 se kam hui 30, then 20, then 10. And time interval is same. Like in first, when body moves with DSLR, it decreases its velocity by 10 here in 5 seconds. Then again decreases by 10 in 5 seconds. So the graph will be for, it is straight line for for uniform retardation. And from non-uniform retardation or deceleration, the graph is not a straight line, maybe curve. The next one is for constant speed or zero acceleration. When your velocity time graph give a slope parallel to time axis, then we can say acceleration is zero or body is moving with constant speed. See here, 5 seconds body is moving with the velocity or with the speed of 30 meter per second. In next 5 seconds again 30 meter per second. In next 5 again 30 meter per second. So the body is moving with the constant speed, and if speed is constant, no direction change is there, then acceleration is zero. And our last graph is for uniform acceleration. When your initial velocity u is not zero, see here, body thi wo zero pe nahi thi, it's moving with 10 meter per second for first 5 second the speed is 10 meter per second, then next 5 second again 10, next 5 again 10, next 5 again 10. So here your uniform acceleration is there, but your velocity, initial velocity, is not zero. So this is a graph for uniform acceleration. Now beta, the slopes are there. These slopes represent acceleration, and the area under the slope, all this these area it give the displacement. This area gives us the measure of displacement. So keep these things in your mind. Do your work carefully. Stay home. Stay safe. Thank you.